the ruler of Kashmir, Maharaja Hari Singh, was worried about the influx of neighboring Punjabis.
I need to protect Jammu Dogras and Kashmiri Pandit lands from being bought over by outsiders.
Egged on by the Dogra and Kashmiri Pandit Pratinidhi Sabhas,
Maharaj, migrants will bypass the law by marrying local women.
He issued a proclamation.
I henceforth forbid Kashmiri women from marrying non-residents, else she would lose her inheritance and all her property rights.
The year was 1927 and India was still under colonial rule. This same law was inserted as Article 35A in the Indian Constitution, ironically by a similar presidential order as the one now, in 1954, 8 years after Jammu and Kashmir acceded to India on October 26, 1947. Muslims were practically serfs then and hardly owned any land. But Sheikh Abdullah's Naya Kashmir program of land to the tiller redistributed it to the valley's Muslims, who too became beneficiaries of 35A. Article 370 came into being as a result of a hasty accession. In late October 1947, Pashtun tribesmen and Pakistani irregulars threateningly crossed the newly made borders in a bid to militarily capture Kashmir. The Maharaja, fearing being overrun and put to death, quickly sent a message.
India, we need your help.
India was ready to help, provided Kashmir joined the Union of India. The Maharaja agreed to a limited arrangement, agreeing to give India rights to handle defense, foreign affairs and communication, while keeping its own separate constitution, its own flag with 3 stripes, each representing the valley, Jammu and Ladakh, with the plough representing the farmers. And instead of adopting India's penal code IPC, followed something called the Ranbir Penal Code, named after the second Dogra ruler Ranbir Singh, under whose reign the code was compiled. This special status was codified as Article 370, and in short, is the genesis of how it came into being and added to India's constitution in 1949. Both these legislations, Article 370 and 35A, instead of protecting Kashmiris, became an albatross around their necks. By disallowing non-Kashmiris to buy property or become permanent residents, as Kashmiris remained agriculturists, the only thing the law has done is made sure Kashmir remained poor and insulated from India's growth and boom in land prices. Jammu and Kashmir politicians opposed the lifting of this law on the grounds
migrating Hindus will change demographics and dilute our religious identity.
But that is just playing on false fears. Neither have Hindus from Jammu nor Buddhists from Leh, despite being Jammu and Kashmir citizens, have migrated into the valley for the last 72 years. On the other hand, demographics changed when Kashmiri Pandits were driven out of their homes in the valley. The law has also been a major injustice on Valmikis, Dalits, brought in from Punjab as government sweepers in 1957, who could never settle down or be permitted to get any other government job, remaining sweepers for life. Hindu and Sikh refugees from West Pakistan remained non-PR, permanent residents, and second-class citizens, while Uyghur Muslims from Xinjiang, China, were given permanent residency. The only place where a large influx has changed demographics in India is the Bengali influx in Assam from both Indian Bengalis and Bangladeshis. However, the question now is the exact opposite. Who will be brave enough to move to the valley or set up a factory in a strife-torn region? India may well look to pursue the Israeli model of creeping acquisition, like in Palestine's West Bank, of giving incentives of free housing and education. The battle now shifts to the Supreme Court, where Abdullah's National Conference has already filed a petition.
Declare the move as unconstitutional, as the president exceeded his powers under Article 371D.
But the government, expecting a challenge, took care. Before moving on 370, they extended the benefits of SCST reservation and quotas to Jammu and Kashmir earlier in the year, but faced no legal challenge. Over the years, even with Article 370 present, several Indian laws have been made applicable to Jammu and Kashmir, diluting its special status. 260 out of 395 articles in the Indian Constitution were made applicable to JNK. 94 out of 97 items in the Union List, that is laws made exclusively by the Union of India and applicable to all states, were extended to Jammu and Kashmir, as were 26 of 47 items in the Concurrent List, that is those laws made jointly by the Union and the state. 40 presidential amendments were made to Jammu and Kashmir since 1954. None were challenged. In the 1972 Mohammad Maqbool Dhanu case, a constitutional bench of the Supreme Court permitted a modification to Article 367(4)(d) to interpret Constituent Assembly to mean the State Legislative Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. It also abolished the Sardar-e-Riyasat position and replaced it by the governor. Article 373 says that the president has the power to amend or abrogate 370 only on the recommendation of the State Assembly. But under president's rule, there is no State Assembly, and the governor is given power to govern the state, who reports directly to the president, because of which powers of the State Assembly now lie directly with the president. Basically, he legally instructed himself to change the status of Article 370. And legally, he did not do anything wrong. However much one argues with the methodology used, former Attorney General of India Soli Surabji believes,
"I don't think challenging it in the court of law will succeed."
In 2016, the Supreme Court in the matter of State Bank of India versus Santosh Gupta ruled that Jammu and Kashmir,
The state does not anymore enjoy elements of sovereignty.
The Supreme Court has already been hearing two petitions for the abrogation of 35A on the grounds that it violates the right to equality of every citizen guaranteed under Article 14, that it was never presented to Parliament and added without amendment under Article 368(1). While two Kashmiri women argued that 35A had disenfranchised their children. A 2002 court order had already made changes to 35A by permitting women to retain their special right upon marrying non-Kashmiris, though it was not extendable to their children. On the other side of the LOC, Pakistan has refrained from making Gilgit-Baltistan its fifth province, keeping it seemingly independent so as not to compromise its claim on Kashmir. However, they gave away a part of POK called Trans-Karakoram Track to China in 1963. Most damning, since 2009, they lifted the special status of POK, Azad Kashmir in Pakistan, permitting outsiders to freely buy land on their side of the LOC. Nehru in 1948 had stated the temporary nature of Article 370 in Parliament.
"It is a provisional arrangement, not a permanent part of the Constitution."
While Home Minister Gulzarilal Nanda in 1964 said much the same thing via an interesting analogy.
"It is neither a wall nor a mountain, but a tunnel through which the laws of India will pass into Kashmir."
UN-appointed Sir Owen Dixon, who went on to become Chief Justice of Jammu and Kashmir, had suggested way back in 1950.
"Bifurcate Jammu and Kashmir into Kashmir Valley, Jammu and Ladakh."
BJP's Vajpayee government did not remove Article 370 because of ideological reasons. "The country has already been broken according to religious lines. We do not want to do the same thing again." But new thinking is necessary now. 10 other Indian states also enjoy special status under the Indian Constitution, where outsiders may not buy property, etc. Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Himachal Pradesh, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Sikkim, Tripura, Uttarakhand. All, as can be seen, are border states and remain backward in terms of development, proof that the law was no good. Technically, 370 is not abolished, just made toothless. Chanakya would be proud. Maybe it's time India truly became one. Bisbo's Limerick. Article 370 was meant as a temporary provision, and over the years it was subject to revision. But it created a status quo for which it had to go, to make place for a new India with a new vision. Subscribe to Bisbo's channel and be sure to click on the bell icon. Be the first to know when Bisbo releases a new video.